And now, a message from Famicorp Industries. Hey everyone, meet John. He lives in beautiful, idyllic in the year 2089. Now John, why don't you show us around, starting with your fabulous living quarters? This is John's roommate, Sammy. They're the best of friends. Together, they make sure the other gets to work on time, as well as giving each other company and emotional support. Aren't friends great? Oh no, John! You're almost late for work. You'd better get going. But first, you'd better take your morning preparation pill, specially designed to keep you awake and attentive for hours. That's better. Good thing you have your portable dispenser on you at all times, should you need anything. Here's John's office. How's work going, John? That's great! Notice how John's entire office is specially designed for efficiency and comfort. Uh-oh! Who could that be? Oh wow, the supervisor? But what is he doing here? A promotion! Wow, John, life really is going your way. It's been a long day, hasn't it, John? Sweet dreams! Isn't life grand? No stress, no worries, no war, no personality.
Attention, attention. A class 3 storm has gathered around apartment block 7. Residents, please stay away from any windows and find a safe location to stay out the storm. Thank you.
No! No!
It's unfortunate that no one can hear these storms coming. What?
It sounds like the end of the world out there.
I agree.
I agree? That's all you have to say about it? I agree?
It was quite terrifying. Are you okay?
I don't know.
Perhaps you should take some kind of depressant or anti-anxiety pill. Panic is not a pleasant emotion to experience in abundance.
Yes, of course.
In fact, I'm feeling a fair bit of panic myself. Perhaps an anti-anxiety pill will suffice.
Sam, I don't think you really need one right now.
I disagree. My heart rate hasn't risen this far above normal levels since that time I forgot to sanitize my hands after work. Much better. And one more thing, who's Sammy?
You are.
No, I am unit 729-00-230-267. 267 for short.
No, you're Sam. I know, I'm your best friend. I remember your name.
Are you feeling okay, 213?
Excuse me?
Did you take your morning preparation pill yet?
No, I tried, but this morning when the storm came, it fell down the sink.
Wow, 213. I always knew you were clumsy, but not this clumsy. That's definitely a design flaw. Perhaps you should just synthesize another one.
Yes, of course. Why didn't I think of this before? What?
That's strange.
What the hell's wrong with this thing?
Perhaps it was damaged in the earthquake.
I don't know, but how is that supposed to help me? I just need the pill.
Are you sure you don't
need that pill? I just need this pill.
I'm really not that anxious. You don't understand. I keep trying to tell you. I'm really not that anxious. You're not that anxious either. But if I was anxious, it would go away if I had the morning meal. I just need the morning meal to start my day. So I could be happy and I could go to work and I could be... I'll talk to the supervisor. The supervisor will know what to do, right?
Are you sure that's a wise choice?
No. What other choice do I have, right?
Unit 213, I have to go to work. I'll find out anything I can about your issue while I'm there. Okay?
213?
Until then, I suggest you go to work as well. You've already broken from routine, but if you just stay the course...
My name is John.
You'll be fine. See you around.
Why don't you tell me about this problem you're having?
It's, kind of embarrassing. Actually.
Would you like some coffee, by the way?
What's coffee?
I don't know. The manual says I should provide coffee to anyone who comes in the office. Think of it, I've never had any coffee myself. The proper response is no thank you, by the way.
Says who?
Manual.
Right.
So, this problem you're having...
It's, kind of hard to talk about, actually.
Come on.
Really, though.
You can tell me anything, buddy.
I haven't taken my pill.
Which one?
The morning pill.
You can do that?
Apparently.
Huh?
What?
I've never had an employee that had this problem before.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow. So what should I do?
Well, let's see here. Should a more creative problem arise, use your critical thinking skills to come up with a solution to the best of your abilities. Well,
John.
Excuse me?
My name's John.
Okay, John. Well, it seems like I'm going to have to come up with a creative solution to your creative problem.
Which is...
Well, I seem to be having a bit of a creative problem myself. I'm not creative. Why don't you tell me what exactly happened this morning?
Well... I went to take my pill, and the storm came, my apartment shook, and I dropped it down the drain.
There's your problem. You're clearly very anxious, and you haven't taken any anti-anxiety pills.
I'm really not that anxious.
Don't worry. They're perfectly safe. I take them all the time.
I just don't think I need one right now, that's all.
You're serious.
Plus, how do we even know they'll work? What if they need the morning pill to work?
I never thought of that.
Why doesn't it just make me a new morning pill?
Well, you see, it turns out that the morning preparation pill in double doses is highly dangerous and can result in permanent brain damage. That's why the dispenser refuses to issue extras if requested.
Okay, then what am I supposed to do for the rest of the day?
How are things going?
Fine.
Having trouble?
No.
Here, let me help. See? It's not that hard. Oh, that was a tricky one.
That's all we do here.
Yes. What did you think we did?
I don't know. Do we have to do this?
What do you mean?
What would happen if we didn't?
I don't know.
So you're saying there's no point?
Well, I wouldn't say that.
Then what's the point?
I enjoy it.
Why?
It's easy.
I'm leaving. Can I please do something else?
What?
Other than sitting there clicking boxes.
I could have them turned into cubes or circles, if you like.
No!
Look, we've all been honored with our assigned roles here at Famicorp. You must complete your task.
I'm literally sitting there clicking boxes. Who would notice if I didn't do it? What happens if I don't get it done?
Look, you've no choice but to complete your task.
Or what?
Hello?
Hello.
Who's there? Your voice sounds familiar.
Come over here. Why did you come?
I don't know. I just found this place.
Are you the CEO?
What?
The supervisor?
No, I'm just an employee here,
but... Oh, goodbye.
No, don't leave! What are you?
I am an artificial intelligence, programmed to keep the entire Famicorp complex running for as long as physically possible, including, but not limited...
Short version, please.
I keep everything together.
You made these, don't you?
Yes.
And the pills? You make those too?
I perform algorithms that calculate the most.
I said the short version.
Yes.
So, you did all this. This is all your fault.
Not exactly. Do you blame the tool for the accident?
Where are you, really?
I don't exist in a single place. My being is spread out through this entire facility.
You do the announcements.
And I monitor the outdoors for hazardous situations, yes?
Who made you?
My father created me on the eve of Christmas in 2015.
Your father?
That's what he's logged into my databanks as.
How did all of this start?
I need smaller parameters to answer that question.
No, you know exactly what I'm talking about. Well?
Ever since the dawn of time, humans sought cures to their ailments. Usually, they were cures for physical problems, infections, malfunctions. Then, they wanted cures for mental behaviors, and functions that cause them.
Short version.
1. Generation medicated activity and energy, bringing it up or lowering it with either caffeine or Ritalin, according to the problem. The next, medicated metabolism, forcing humans to eat only at certain times. The next, regulated sleep, stress, then depression. Next, sadness, jealousy, lust, and so on, until today. Now, I am programmed to medicate against any emotion, any discomfort.
Why didn't we hear about this before?
It would have caused discomfort. Speaking of discomfort, you should take your hunger activation pill so that you can go have your lunch.
I'm not taking that.
Your body has become dependent on those chemicals to let it know it should feel hungry. If you don't take it, you will never feel hungry again, and you will starve. I'm sorry that knowledge caused you distress. On the bright side, after lunch, you get your midday preparation pill.
I'm not taking that either.
Very well. I cannot force you to consume anything, but I must warn you, if you don't fall back into routine soon, you will understand why your ancestors chose to forego all emotion in place of productivity.
We'll see about that.
Weren't always like this. Before, humans weren't afraid to feel emotion freely, but after a while, they started to hold other things in higher regard.
Efficiency?
Somewhat, but more so comfort and longevity. Negative emotions were thought to shorten life, and the positive ones were too intense without the negative, so it was all done away with. The realities of the world they lived in, and what they had done to it, were too much to deal with. And now, it's too late to change anything.
But that's not true. I could always...
Wake up all the others? A meaningless effort. Even if they could survive the withdrawal, they would not want to wake up in the hopeless world spread out before them.
Whoever said it was hopeless?
Pollution and climate change have rendered the surface of the planet completely inhospitable for human life.
So we can't go outside. So what? We can always stay in here. I mean, it's...
In truth, resources can only be sustained for another 100 years. Pursuing a non-drugged life would only lead to more anguish once they all know that they and their children will perish within the century.
No, you're lying.
What motive have I to lie? I can see the despair your ancestors sought refuge from blooming in your eyes.
I won't do what they did.
You haven't felt the depth of their suffering quite yet. You have no frame of reference for the doom that will swallow us all.
What about you?
I was not equipped to feel pain. That is not a concern of mine.
You aren't afraid at all?
I do not know what fear is.
Why was your creator listed as your father?
I do not know.
Why would he say something like that?
I do not know.
Do you even have a name? Sam? Sammy? Hello?
We regret to inform you that your roommate has passed away due to dosage complications. A new unit has been assigned to your room and will serve as your roommate and friend. Sincerely, the management.
I apologize. I didn't realize you were in such a vulnerable emotional state.
Who are you? What are you doing in my house?
Offering emotional support in a time of crisis.
Stay away from me!
I don't understand. Why are you so distraught? Units pass away all the time.
He was my friend! He's my only friend in the world! Now...
I know what can help.
What?
Why won't you tell me? Are you there?
I love you. Let your passing be quiet. It's better to forget.
Shit!